We're on the road this morning at the Iowa State Fair. After being canceled by COVID in 2020, the fair is back with its familiar corn dogs, deep fried Twinkies, butter cow, and a new offering this year. Vaccine on a stick. CNN's Donie O'Sullivan live in Des Moines. Donie, what you seeing out there, buddy?
Hey, John. Yeah, Marjorie Taylor Greene bringing her anti-science, anti-vaccine message to the fair here in Iowa. But there is some good news. There is a vaccine tent here, and they are seeing people who were vaccine hesitant now ready to get their shot. Have a watch.
What'd you guys have for lunch?
Corn dogs.
You all had corn dogs.
No, I had ribs.
This year at the Iowa State Fair, corn dogs, cheese curds, and a 1,300-pound boar named Irish Cowboy.
Any idea why they named this hog the Irish Cowboy?
Is it an Irish breed?
I hope not.
And here as well this year, a vaccine center and two controversial members of Congress.
I don't know if you've heard of Marjorie Taylor Greene and Matt Gaetz.
Oh, God, don't get me started on her either.
No. They're coming here tomorrow.
Oh, thank God, I won't be here.
Not a fan?
No, can't stand that woman. She needs to keep her mouth shut.
What is it you don't like about her?
She just needs to keep her mouth shut because most of it comes out of it is stupidity, idiotic phrases that she doesn't back up.
Green brought her anti-science message to Iowa, repeating false claims about masks and vaccines.
I'm completely against masks. They don't work. They're not stopping the spread of COVID. I'm also completely against forced vaccines. The vaccines are failing.
What do you think of Green showing up here to the state fair?
I think it's great. I think it's a great way to get in touch with the people of Iowa.
Can I ask, have you been vaccinated?
I have not been vaccinated.
Would you consider getting the vaccine if more businesses, there's parts of the country now where you can only go into a restaurant if you have proof of a vaccine?
No, I'm not for that. This is America, and we are a free country of free people. We have the right to decide what goes on with our bodies.
I'm not vaccinated, and I'm not going to get vaccinated. Our days are numbered. It don't matter whether it's COVID or I get in that truck and go over down the highway and get hit by a semi or T-bone and killed. It don't matter, you know. Life is what it is, you know. We take it how God gives it to us.
But you wear a seatbelt, right?
Well, of course.
So
but there's 50-50 chance that'll save you or it won't save you.
But isn't that sort of like taking a vaccine? You take the steps
to
protect yourself when you can?
No. I'm not taking the jab.
What would it take to convince you to get the vaccine?
I'm not sure that I could be convinced, but, you know, I'm open to looking at, you know, scientific evidence, real scientific evidence, not just something they're spoon-feeding everyone.
He may be unable to be convinced, but these men got their COVID shots at the fair.
Today was your first shot?
Oh, yes, it's my first shot.
And why did you decide to get it?
I felt that when I'm traveling and around other people and things like that, it wouldn't be a very good decision that I were making on that one.
We've had a lot of people stop and just talk to us. Some we've encouraged and are, after the conversation, they've been willing to come in and get their vaccine.
Chuck Morgenstern and Vernon Hoover man the Magic Maze and Rock and Roll Funhouse here. They say their decision to get the shot was in part because the next fair they are going to require staff to be vaccinated, and in part because they realized it was the safer thing to do.
Had you any concerns about the vaccine?
Well, I heard that other even though people have the vaccine, they still ended up getting COVID-19, so that was kind of a concern, but Now that we're working the fairs and most of us don't wear masks anymore and all this and that, so I wanted to be better protected. Everyone should go on, and if they haven't had the vaccine, they should go on and take it.
When I'm back tonight, I've got to drop by the maze. See you guys.
So, John, as you can see, there are some folks who were a bit hesitant about the vaccine now ready to get the shot. But also, as you saw, some people, no matter what you tell them, no matter what people say and tell them, despite all the science, they will not get this shot.
You heard the people Donie spoke with in Iowa. They believe the lies from Republican politicians like Marjorie Taylor Greene. We're seeing this across the country. But is there anything that can actually stop this dangerous information?
that can stop the dangerous information from getting out? No, it's out. It's really amazing. I mean, that clip that you guys played from Marjorie Taylor Greene, she's considered a fringe member, but I think her messaging, no masks, no mandates, is right in the wheelhouse of where the hard right is right now. And if you listen to things that Florida Governor Ron DeSantis is saying, comparing mask mandates to medical authoritarianism, that's where it's at. And what's just amazing to me, Don, when you talk about the disinformation, is they all do this dance where you can get the vaccine if you want, but then they go and indulge in every concern that someone might have not to get it. Well, at the same time, like, we've peddled every other thing except the vaccine. There was like herd immunity, hydroxychloroquine, this horse dewormer, you know, now they're pushing the antibodies, and we have the answer. It's the vaccine. But because Trump has politicized this whole mess so much, they're looking towards everything else except for what works, mandates and masks.
Well, it's interesting because if you get the monoclonal, you're actually putting stuff into your body to the vaccine. But it's just that you've gotten sick and your chances of recovery are worse. And, oh, boy, I can't make hair on our high. Okay, so listen, Ron, I have to get your take on this. This is some breaking news, and it's out of Texas. The Supreme Court is refusing to intervene on mask mandates issued by several local jurisdictions. So, but listen, basically tonight, because I think we're overcomplicating it here, the courts now have agreed that Texas can mandate masks unless and until this litigation or whatever goes further. So what does this all mean right now? Is this...
First of all, the extent of the open defiance and rebellion that we're seeing in Texas with now, I think, dozens of school districts is truly extraordinary. I mean, every large metro in the state now is openly defying what the governor wants to do. And the governor and the attorney general, Ken Paxton, tried to get basically do an end run on the courts and ask the state Supreme Court to intervene immediately to block all of these local mask mandates. And what the state Supreme Court said today was, no, you have to go through the regular process. You have to go through the appellate level before we will weigh in. Strikingly, Don, on the same day today that happened, the Texas Education Agency said they will not enforce Governor Abbott's ban on mask mandates until all the litigation is done. And when you take those two things together, it could be a signal that some Republicans, certainly the Republicans, all of the state Supreme Court is entirely Republicans, are looking for a way off of the ledge that the governor has moved the party to on this. And by the way, this comes as the county judge, in effect, the county supervisor in Dallas County, announced a few days ago that there were literally no pediatric ICU beds available in North Texas. And the head of the Texas Medical Center in Houston said today that 20% of their cases are kids. So Abbott and Paxton has taken the Republicans to an extreme position, one that could threaten their hold on the suburban voters, which are still critical in deciding the balance of power in this state. And it's not clear where the next stage goes. It's not over yet, though.
Ron, listen, also DeSantis and Abbott keep fighting with local officials over masks. And listen, you've been looking into this and you found the important similarity about where these feuds are happening. What is that? Tell me about that.
Well, look, I mean, what we're watching is extraordinary. I mean, we have never seen, I think, anything like the open defiance of this many large jurisdictions to efforts from the Republicans to override and preempt their decision. I mean, basically, what we are seeing is that the governor in each state, in both Texas and in Florida, are trying to override decisions in counties that voted against them. I mean, if you look at all of the big counties in Florida that are trying to impose the mask mandates, Miami-Dade, Palm Beach, Broward, Hillsborough, Osceola, Alachua, and maybe Orange County, which is Orlando tomorrow, they all voted against DeSantis in 2018. And similarly in Texas, all of the big counties except for Tarrant County voted against Abbott. And so what we are seeing, I think, Don, here is the crystallization of what has been a long developing dynamic, where you have this Republican coalition in the Sun Belt states that is rooted in their dominance of preponderantly white, non-urban areas, using their statewide power to override the decisions of diverse, info-age, increasingly secular big metros that are driving the economy and the population. And this is the moment, I think, where we are seeing the breaking point and those metros pushing back. And it's going to produce epic battles, I think, for the governorships in 2022 in Florida, in Georgia, in Arizona, and maybe in Texas, although it's less clear there the Democrats will have a top-tier candidate.